Hello, my besties. Welcome to another reaction. I got a song here today called Heroin. It's by the Velvet Underground. It was requested for by Din Java. Let's go check it out.
Just where I'm going, but I'm gonna try for the kingdom if I can, 'cause it makes me feel like I'm a man when I put a spike into my vein.
Vocalist, he reminds me of Lou Reed. You know, it doesn't say featuring Lou Reed, so I don't know, but it reminds me of him a lot. You know, the song, I'm thinking that musically what it's doing here is, you know, it starts very, very slow and it's like a build up, and I think maybe it's like maybe it's like how you feel just before you get the fix, you know. And when you get that fix, things just become frantic and like 190 miles per hour, because it just gets, you know, the music gets faster, the drum is pumping, you know, and the music just gets hectic. And I think maybe that's what they're doing there. And if that's what they're doing, that's brilliant. Although you cannot say, you know, Heroin is brilliant, but you know what I mean. Let's check out some more.
Have me. Decision. I'm gonna try to nullify my life, 'cause when the blood begins to flow and it shoots up the dropper's neck, when I'm closing in on death,
doesn't that drum, doesn't it sound like a heartbeat to you guys? It does, you know, it sounds like the heartbeat is, you know, the heart is pumping, you know, and like I was saying earlier on, maybe that's the franticness I was like talking about. Maybe you know, when you get hyper, your heart also starts to, like, you know, or when you're excited, your heart pounds faster as well. So maybe that's supposed to be like actually a heartbeat. Clever stuff.
Wish that I was born 1,000 years ago, raging seas on a great big clipper ship, going from this land here to that on a sailor's suit and cap. Away from the big city where a man cannot be free of all of the evils of this town and of himself, and looks around. Oh, and I guess that I just don't know. Oh, and I guess that I just don't know. Death of me. Heroine. It's my wife and it's my life. Because a manor to my vein leads to a center in my head, and then I'm better.
The way he said heroin, you know, it sent shivers down my spine. And when he said, you know, it will be the death of me, it's my wife and my life. When you hear somebody say things like that, you know, and to think some people have actually felt that way, and some people have felt that way as well because they think it's because they've tried so hard and so long to get off it, and they couldn't get off it. They just resigned to the fact that, you know, this will be the death of me, you know. And that is so sad because it's taken so many lives, it's destroyed so many lives, you know. And something that's that sad as just like a, you know, a little bit of fun, you know, maybe at a party or whatever, you know, it now comes to like dominate and take control of your whole life. And it's not only your life, it's also the life of the people around you as well. And this music, the mood of it, right, the way it was created, right, when you hear it, it's not happy music, you know. It sounds like disturbed music, you know. You hear it and you think to yourself, something is not quite right. So that it was very clever that they could get that mood. But I must confess, you know, listening to the lyrics, right, it just sends shivers down my spine, you know. I'm just like so thankful that this is not my bag, you know, because I cannot imagine being caught up in all that.
Because when the smack begins to flow, I really don't care anymore about all the gym gyms. Putting everybody else down, and all the dead bodies piled up in mounds.
They've also used the music to represent all the chaos around him, you know, You hear him saying he doesn't care about all the politicians and all the things happening, in town. It's like he's found solace in his heroin, and maybe part of those things, are what made him get into it in the first place. Maybe he had too many problems or whatever, and he just thought, I need to get lost and get, or escape for a bit. And he's found himself here. Total nightmare.
Thank God that I'm good as dead, and thank your God that I'm not aware.
Very eerie, that really sent shivers down my spine, I tell you, man. The lyrics, and they were like some really, really deep stuff there, I just wonder if the person who wrote the song, was a recovering addict, was still an addict, or maybe he just had friends around him that he like studied. Because some of the things that he was saying here, he was saying things like, when he feels like a man is when he shoots up, And he was saying things like, don't, to all his friends and all his well wishes, don't even try to sweet talk me. Don't even try to like change me around because I'm happy where I am. And then he says, thank God that I'm not aware of what I'm doing, because I don't care. I'm better off dead. He wants to nullify his life, he says. And then he says, heroin will be the death of me. So he knows that himself. Say it's because it's my wife, it's my life. It's just it's and then he also talks about, all the people in town putting each other down, all the politicians with all their tricks and all the gyms or something like that. And basically, right, it's like he wants to escape from all the negative things that's happening around him, and he's just like giving up on life basically, really. And he wants to get lost, and not have to face up to reality. Just crazy stuff, man. I don't know if he was actually like thinking that way when he was actually like sane, or maybe it's the heroin that's made him like, not give a damn about anything. Deep stuff, man. I'm just thankful. I wish I knew the story behind this, I really do. And what I meant by that is about the writer, why he wrote the song. Maybe some of you will like fill us in the comment section. Anyway, thanks for stopping by. Those of you who found me for the first time today, I welcome you on board. I hope to see you here again. Also, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to give it a big like or a thumbs up so that YouTube can share it to many more people. I might have to like edit the title because they might see heroin and think to themselves, "What is this?" Anyway, stay cool, stay safe out there. If you have any like things that you indulge in, be careful. Most of all, stay beautiful in your heart and soul, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.